Alrighty guys, and welcome to part 2 of Beast in the East. We got ourselves a fatal 4-way cruiserweight match. I think everyone in this is cruiserweight. I know for sure 2 of them are. Neville, I'm pretty sure, is a cruiserweight, and I think Tyson. So we got TJ Perkins, Brian Kendrick, Neville, and Tyson Kidd. I'm pretty sure Tyson Kidd counts as a cruiserweight too. If he doesn't, then he's going to be counted as one anyways. We got 4 cruiserweights and a fatal 4-way to start off part 2 of Beast in the East.
And his opponent.
And we see Brian Key.
Orlando,
wow. Couldn't even finish his name.
Because
WWE likes to restrict you with finishing names.
Kendrick.
If you guys didn't see the first part, make sure you guys do check that out. We had an amazing tag team match. We had a rematch from SmackDown Live, but we had a nice triple threat. As we see Tyson Kidd now making his way in the ring. I might have to change up his attire. I like the long pants that they just showed in the Titantron. I might put on the long pants. And our last man to get in the match is the man that defies gravity, Neville. His entrance video looks so cool. Oh, I forgot. He wears the red in this too, right? I totally forgot. I thought he still wore the purple. I might change the tire to blue. I like the color blue. Or maybe a lighter red. A lighter red would look good too. TJ Perkins, Brian Kendrick, Tyson Kidd, and Neville. So we get this match up started. There we go. Who's going after? Everybody just go. All right, so we got Neville taking on TJ Perkins. And we got Tyson Kidd taking on to Brian Kendrick. Brian Kendrick quickly rolling out of the ring, getting back inside. Neville being taken out. And now Neville's already taken out of the match. What's TJ Perkins doing, though? He took the long way to get to him. Might not be very smart of TJ. So you see TJ Perkins, though, going for a nice back suplex, taking him out. Outside the ring, you gotta take him out early. And Neville reversing. Huge kick to the gut to TJ Perkins. And right into the steel steps, and now Neville getting inside the ring. What is Neville thinking? Oh, look at Brian Kendrick.
He doesn't want to do this outside the ring. Well, I don't blame
Huge drop kick to the legs of TJ Perkins. Oh, and look at that leg, almost at a leg breaker. Nice reversal after reversal. As we see now the men are switching. I was going to say nice move by, oh, nice. Oh my God, I can't even talk. Every time I try to say something else pops up. And TJ Perkins rolling outside of the ring. Huge move so far. And now the neck breaker once again. Back breaker turned into a neck breaker, and now Neville has been taken out. So now it is only Brian Kendrick and Tyson Kidd in this matchup. And that's how you want it. You want it as a one-on-one. You can get the win early. Both men getting back up. TJ again. Wait a minute. What is Brian Kendrick doing? 450 splash.
Neville,
and Neville gets taken
here.
Out with a nice backbreaker.
Right,
backbreaker. Back suplex once
me,
again. And again,
ring.
Right into
the
steel steps.
Doesn't appear to be doing him any good.
Well, Tyson Kidd, nice leg drop.
Plenty of fight left in him. He's starting to stagger a bit.
And Tyson Kidd gets drop kicked by Neville.
Here in this four-way environment. And at this point, it looks to me like this
TJ Perkins back inside the ring.
It's a good point, John.
And TJ and Neville going straight after each other, but oh, Brian Kendrick's breaking it up.
He's on the defensive.
Nice takedown by Brian Kendrick. Next Exeguri by Neville. And the moonsault to Brian Kendrick. Both men have been taken out. Neville getting back up.
There's a lot of truth in that statement, especially when referring to this guy, John.
A nice suplex. Tyson Kidd going up top. Tyson Kidd's up top. What's he thinking of doing? He's taunting. He's taunting. But no, Neville not letting it happen. Oh, but a reversal by Tyson. Oh, whoa. Taken out. Thought he was going to take out Neville, but he almost took out Brian Kendrick. He's hanging on the ropes. Huge gut buster by Tyson Kidd. And now Brian Kendrick has been taken out. followed by TJ Perkins, who was going to attack him on the outside. Tyson Kidd, what's Tyson Kidd thinking of doing here? Tyson Kidd looks like he went for his finishing maneuver, but it did not work. Neville with the huge kick to the back.
Bringing it back inside.
Now, three men are back inside. Will Brian Kendrick make it four again? Yes, he will. And all four men are back inside the ring. Brian Kendrick going straight after TJ Perkins, picking him up. What's he going for? A nice neck breaker.
Now that's a finishing move. This thing might be.
What's Kendrick doing? Kendrick taking him into the... Oh, wait a minute. You know what Kendrick's going for, but it didn't work. It didn't work.
He'll need to find a way to create some space if he wants to win this fatal four-way match.
Wait a minute. Ooh, right on the face of Tyson Kidd.
Pride is a big factor in this one, Cole.
But no. Oh, CJ taking him out. Looked like Neville wanted to go for the red arrow, but it didn't work. TJ took him out.
It takes more and more effort.
And TJ should have went straight for the pin on Tyson instead, taking Neville back inside the ring. I don't know if that's very smart if you see Tyson knocked out. Oh, wait, but TJ. No, but no, Tyson goes right after the pin. He went straight for the pin. And TJ's mad.
Struggling to stand
after Russian leg sweep. And TJ looks like he's going for Brian Kendrick, but no. Tyson again. Oh, almost rolling out the ring, but instead getting back up to his... What is Brian Kendrick doing? What is Kendrick doing? Kendrick, oh, Kendrick calling for him to get up. TJ Perkins reversed it. Drop kick by the Brian Kendrick. And wait a minute, TJ Perkins. Is that his finishing maneuver? I think it was. And Brian Kendrick doesn't see it. Brian Kendrick, oh, but no, Tyson kicked out. Kendrick didn't see it, but Tyson kicked out.
Jeez, after that one, he definitely has to muster
Tyson Kidd
comeback.
Now taking Perkins inside.
You don't have just one opponent in there. You've
no. Almost at inside the corner. Onto the corner. Back and forth go. Oh, and TJ's taken out. Couldn't even finish. Back and forth goes Brian and Neville. TJ Perkins gets taken out once again. Kendrick gets taken out by the Exeguri. Now both men just stomping out Kendrick.
This is awful. I'm going to tell you something. Whenever you
get
what
a drop like kick
that,
to Kendrick.
15 minutes, everybody you see has an exact
and a drop kick to Neville.
I can guarantee you the kid didn't learn that in the dungeon. Boy,
nice
he is
and
really
kid.
Tired now. That tank of his has
pulling
to
him
be
center
re-empty.
Of the ring. It what is he going for? Working well, on the legs of Neville, trying to slow him down. Making sure Neville can't get up top to hit the red arrow. Taking him down with the Northern Light suplex. Wait, okay. Okay, TJ
nobody
though. TJ
that.
Though.
Nobody
look out. What a nice elbow TJ. Drop.
Now that's a finishing move.
He's this back up to his feet. And TJ Perkins.
Over.
Whoa, nice neck breaker. But no, he rolls out.
Point,
that could have been it. I could have swore that. Was that his finisher before? I don't remember if that was his finisher or not before. Wait a minute, TJ looking like, oh, TJ looked like he wanted to go for his finisher, but instead both men, wait, they're both going for their finisher, but who's going to grab it? And it was TJ to get it, no, but Tyson taking him down. Tyson did not let it happen. And a drop kick, but he missed. Brian Kendrick getting taken out, but no, he reversed it. Brian Kendrick.
Great counter, and he dodges that one.
Neville back and forth, but Neville going up top. Neville's going up top. Will we see the red arrow? Yes, we will, red arrow. Could that be it? And what just happened? Oh, that's the replay. Okay, I was going to say what just happened. The replay, the red arrow. One. TJ's back up. Tyson's back up. No, but Neville, he gets the victory here tonight. To start off the episode, what an amazing, amazing matchup. We're going to skip the replay. Actually, we should watch the Red Arrow one more time. Oh, that was amazing. Neville picking up a huge victory here tonight. Taking out Brian Kendrick, Tyson Kidd, and TJ Perkins. Let's get on with the next matchup of the night. And for our second matchup in part two of Beast in the East, he is here. Eddie Guerrero is back.
The following contest,
I'm so happy they actually put him in the game.
Making his way to the ring.
Actually, this is my first time actually getting to see him in the game. I've never played as him. I've never seen his... Actually, oh, wait. Oh, I think it's because of the stage. Certain stages, they don't have his car entrance. That kind of sucks.
And his opponent,
he will be taking on Rusev. I'm actually kind of upset that this stage... I gotta take a look at the stage. I'm pretty sure there's enough room for him to get the car in. Maybe not. I have no idea as we get this map. Why does Mana's hair look pink?
That's traveling through this arena.
Oh, this is the first time actually locking up.
I think it's safe to say the roof of this building.
This is the first time locking up. I've never seen the lockup before.
Yeah, and social media has been on fire ahead of this one.
As we see Eddie Guerrero taking a sneak shot on Rusev and now going for the slam.
But regardless, this is just another in a long line of
Eddie Guerrero now taunting. He's glad to be back in the WWE. First time in universe mode.
I'm so happy
they brought him into the game. Oh, wait a minute. Roll up.
No gimmicks here.
One, two, already on Rusev. No.
That's the thing. In the WWE,
thought he was going to get a quick pin on Rusev as we did DDT. How are you guys enjoying this little mini pay-per-view? I think the match card came out pretty good. I mean, I'm pretty much forced to say it. I have to like my own stuff, but I honestly love how it came out.
But it doesn't end there.
I think it came out pretty good. It probably could have came out a little bit better if actually. Ooh, nice arm drag breaker arm thing. I think it would have came out a lot better if I probably incorporated the rivalries and stuff. But I kind of wanted to let other people shine without, you know, having to have a bunch of rivalries and stuff. You see Eddie Guerrero destroying Rusev right now. Eddie Guerrero going up top. Rusev making it back to his feet. Eddie Guerrero falls outside the ring. Why does Lana's hair look pink? It looks pink. It's blonde, right? I think her hair is blonde. It looks
matched by one other aspect.
Maybe it's because of the lighting? I don't know, but maybe either that or I could be tripping, but I'm pretty sure it's pink right now. You see Rusev taking it to Eddie Guerrero. What is he doing? Stomping him in the gut. You know what kind of sucks? When you change the referee. What I didn't notice, oh, nice kick to the face of Rusev. What I noticed is that, oh, nice clothesline. When you change the referee, the voice stays the same. This is the Japanese referee. So we see Eddie Guerrero going for a drop kick. The Rusev reverses it. It's a Japanese referee, but he still sounds like the normal referee. Ooh, spinning heel kick. Rusev is taking control once again, picking up Eddie Guerrero and slamming him back down. Double axe handle to the back.
To bounce back though. This is the type of one-on-one.
Stomping Eddie Guerrero out. What's he going for?
I tell you, we knew this was going to be a close
Eddie Guerrero
affair,
reversing it. Going for a DDT. Eddie Guerrero.
What a match.
Hits the DDT.
Is
Eddie Guerrero healing the game? Because the crowd's booing him. And they shouldn't be. Nice exit. All right, let's try again. There we go. I can hear a little bit more taunt. A little bit more taunt. A little bit more cheers. I don't know. Eddie Guerrero accidentally hitting the rev down. I don't think that was on purpose. So you see Eddie now up top. Eddie Guerrero with the reversal. Eddie. Hurricane Rana, but no Rusev. Power bombing him down. Rusev has a counter for everything. Eddie's shooting at him right now. Slamming him face first. And now just stomping Eddie. Rusev now. Rusev with the huge super kick. Eddie might be in trouble. 2-3. No. Eddie Guerrero kicking out of the super kick. Wait a minute. No. This might be at the accolade. The accolade on Eddie. The accolade on Eddie. Eddie might tap. Oh, Eddie slips out. Eddie slipped out. Eddie Guerrero. Wait a minute, Eddie Guerrero. Is he going for the three amigos? two. Will we see the third one? Yes, we will.
This is amazing.
Oh, wait a minute. What's Lana doing? What is Lana doing? Looks like she's trying to distract Eddie. Eddie's not having it, though. Going for the pin on Rusev, who kicks out. Look at Eddie just staring at Lana. Hey, why did Eddie just look at Lana like that?
So much resolve.
What's he going for?
Going to take a minor miracle.
No, wait, Eddie just picked. Actually. Why do I sound so surprised when he already did it? Not even going to sound surprised that he did because he already did it.
Rusev,
nice uppercut.
He doesn't want to let this match get out of control, guys.
Nice knee to the back by Eddie Guerrero. And now a drop kick. It looks like, yes, it is. Eddie. What's Eddie going for here?
This one was over sooner than later. Boy, he just got laid.
He's just taunting. He's taunting. Is he going for the frog splash? No, he's not. He didn't go for the...
He's looking for the win. This maybe is. He's delivering it.
I thought he was going for the frog splash there, but no. And again, Rusev with the counter. Back and forth. And oh, going straight for the pin. Couldn't even finish my sentence. Back and forth, and Eddie kicks out once again.
You can practically
now
feel
stomping
the
on Eddie once again.
That's been done throughout
trying to
this
slow
match.
Eddie's pace down. Huge chop. He's trying to slow Eddie down. The quickness of Eddie. And a huge. Oh, he did he miss? Oh, he missed it. He was at Jaguri, but he misses the Exaguri.
It doesn't get much better than this.
And Eddie Guerrero now pulling him back, but no, Rusev belly to belly. Huge stomp to
the
face of Eddie Guerrero.
I've ever seen him in.
And again, another quick pin by Rusev. And another kick out by Eddie. Eddie Guerrero is in big trouble. What is Rusev thinking of doing? Eddie Guerrero gets taken out. And what is... What is Rusev doing? No, Eddie reverses, though. Eddie reverses. Eddie's too quick, but no, Lana. Lana. She's distracting Guerrero. And Eddie gets taken down once again, but no, he rolls out of the ring. And he's just staring. He's following Lana. He's following Lana. And he's just taunting now. Eddie runs back inside the ring, followed by Rusev. Huge hit to the back. Flipping him down the way to Guerrero. Wait a minute. I think he just busted him open. Eddie just busted Rusev open. And what is Rusev doing? Eddie Guerrero shooting Rusev down. Wait a minute. Guerrero. Almost an Exaguri. Hurricane Rana. And this might be it, Guerrero. Frog splash. The frog splash. To Rusev. Oh, come on. Stupid replays. One. Two. What is Lana doing?
He's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously wrong there.
What is Lana? Lana just caught. What? Eddie Guerrero punching Rusev. And now drop kicking him. Oh, but he missed the drop kick. He missed the drop kick.
He anticipated that move.
Another reversal by Eddie. Eddie with the huge hits. Eddie with the huge hits. Eddie Guerrero now shooting Rusev outside of the ring. Right in front of Lana. Eddie, wait a minute. Eddie, what is Eddie doing? What is Eddie doing? Don't do it, Eddie. Suicide dive to Rusev right into the barricade.
Does this building have a curfew? I feel like we might be here.
Eddie Guerrero putting his whole body on the line. And Eddie Guerrero, what's he going for? He's just taunting now.
A little intimidation there. You don't want to get
Eddie Guerrero getting back inside the ring now. Guerrero. Just taunting now. He's just waiting for Rusev to get back into the ring. Rusev's finally getting back inside Eddie. Rusev running into Eddie, but Eddie reversing it. Jumping over him. Huge uppercut.
This far. It's been so physical. You're right
Guerrero.
About that, Cole. This has been an all-out war.
Guerrero now, is he going for the three amigos once again? One. Wait a minute. Hold on. That's two it. Amigos.
What a finishing move. This could be
two amigos.
Right.
No, he's going to go for another frog splash. Second frog splash. Good night. Stupid replays. And Lana is distracting the referee once again. But the pin. Lana's nowhere near the ref. Two. No, Rusev again kicking out. Lana again cost Eddie the win once again. He could have got it, but she distracted him. What? Wow, Lana. Drop kick to the knees of Eddie. Not of Eddie, from Eddie. Wait a minute, Eddie. Roll up in the middle of the ring. Middle of the ring. One, there's a chair. Does it matter? He got him.
And that was win.
Drop kick to the legs. The legs gave out. What is this, the three amigos or the two amigos? Oh, it doesn't matter because we didn't see it. That was definitely the three. The roll up in the middle of the ring. Lana, she couldn't stop the ref this time. She didn't even see Rusev get pinned. Eddie Guerrero is victorious here tonight. Eddie Guerrero. What is Eddie doing? Look at Lana. Lana's mad.
And it looks like this
Eddie Guerrero's just
floor.
Leaving. Congratulations, Eddie Guerrero, for picking up the victory here tonight in his debut here in Universe Mode. Wow. Look at Eddie. Oh my God, I love him. Alrighty guys, and for the main event here at Beast in the East, we got the Beast. The Beast Incarnate. The 1-21-1. The Paul Heyman guy, Brock Lesnar. I can't say it like how Paul Heyman does. But he has taken on Braun Strowman here tonight in the main event. I had so much trouble picking a worthy opponent for Brock Lesnar. But I think I chose the right choice in picking Braun to see if he can defeat Brock Lesnar. God, I love that mask. It's amazing.
And his opponent,
Braun Strowman. His beard is pretty cool too. I love beards. Beards are awesome, man. Look at Brock's face. Beards are freaking amazing. I love them. Brock going right after Braun, but Braun tackling him down.
What's on the line here? Oh, you're right.
And just taunting in Brock's face. And ooh, chopping him down. Huge punch to the face.
Find out about themselves real quick. Regardless, people will look back on this night.
But no, Brock couldn't keep him up. Brock couldn't keep Braun up. Ooh, and Braun just looking. What is Paul Heyman doing? Paul Heyman's distracting Braun.
Head to head, no excuses. Let's get
but no,
it
Braun reversing
you know,
it. Huge kick to the gut and needed to face the Lesnar.
I mean, this matchup proves that
Braun is looking mighty strong
career.
So far, and the match just started. Look at Lesnar. Lesnar's struggling to get up to his feet.
I gotta tell you. I've seen some monsters
and just taking Brock down.
Business, but none like Brock
a
Lesnar.
Huge kick to the back, but a reversal.
The
now they got a chair.
They
got a chair in the match. Will that be used? That is the question. Braun. Wait a minute. What is Braun doing? What is? No, hold on. Is that even legal? Right into the chair. Is that even legal? I guess it is. The ref didn't call a DQ.
Oh, look at that.
No, Brock Lesnar kicks out. This matchup is not over just yet.
The thing about Brock Lesnar, and Jerry, you touched on this earlier.
Brock, I don't think Brock is yet. Ooh, the ref got taken out. I don't think Brock is yet to get a hit on him. Look at Braun shooting Brock across the ring. The strength of Strowman. And Brock finally getting some. Brock finally fighting back.
If you want to be scared out of your shoes, just take a look.
And Lesnar just stomping him out now.
In the locker room and the audience.
Lesnar finally getting some hits in.
For that one.
Well, it certainly wasn't due to a lack
suplex
of trying,
Michael. Oh, man, is he going to Suplex City? Are we going to see Suplex City coming early? Look at the anger on Brock's face.
In the pantheon of finishers, Brock Lesnar's
what is Brock doing? He's taunting Braun.
Does it not?
Oh, without a doubt.
Lesnar doesn't care.
That the beast is subjected to that move is like a who's who of WWE greats.
He's doing picking up Braun Strowman, slamming him down. Strowman not looking too strong anymore. Brock has him exactly where he wants him. Axe handling him right back down. And that's exactly what you got to do. You got to keep Braun off his feet for as long as you can.
It's important to know that this match has been so evenly
contested. Oh, and again, he couldn't keep Braun up. But Heyman again.
And this could really go either way.
Heyman again. Another suplex.
The Brock Lesnar's F5 victims. The one that stands out the most to me is Big Show.
Flipping him over, Brock Lesnar.
7 foot tall, 500-pound giant.
The Battle of the Behemoths. Oh my God. Two of the toughest men in WWE Universe right now. Lesnar going for Suplex City, but no. Did not work.
I'm not sure how much more he has to give.
And a huge punch once again.
But at some point, one of them got to start pulling away, which is
Strowman. Another one just punching him down once again. Oh, that scared the crap out of me.
No quit in him.
And now just shooting Brock Lesnar right out of the ring.
Looks like this one's going up to the floor. What was your first clip?
Braun just screaming.
Brock Lesnar performed on the Big Show at the Royal
Rumble. Waiting for Brock to get up to his feet. He's actually waiting for Brock to get back up.
Alrighty, and I am back. The dogs were disrespecting me by barking when I was making a video, so I had to shut them up with my savageness. Alright, get back in the ring, Brock. We got a match. Not really. Braun is just demolishing him.
Huge shoulders. Now chomping him down.
Quit running your mouth and let them do this thing.
And again, Heyman. Distracting Strowman. And Lesnar now, another back suplex, taking him down hard.
Remember Thursday, Raw Thursday?
Heyman needs to calm down. You don't want to make Braun mad. Kick out at one. You do not want to make Strowman mad. That is probably the last person you want to make mad. And again, taking Brock down. Didn't look like he hit too hard, though. And yep. He did not.
What
a spear outside the ring.
Look out.
You can hear the crowd. Suplex City. Alright, so we know whose side they're on. We know whose side the crowd's on. They're on Brock's side. Now taking Braun back inside the ring. Huge big boot to Strowman.
He's too busy bragging.
Okay.
Back between the ropes.
Look at cocky Lesnar over here.
To his feet here.
Whoa, look at cocky
expect,
Brock Lesnar. Oh, no. Suplex City. There it is, and the crowd is going wild. Another one. There we go. And Lesnar, instead of going for the pin, he stomps him. Lesnar is not done. He's trying to punish. Why did I just say punish like that? He's trying to punish Strowman. Man, I am an idiot sometimes. We see Strowman getting the knee to the face.
The drama. This is electric.
Is he going for the pin now? He's going for the pin now.
Shoulders down.
One, two, three. No, Strowman kicks out at two. Look how far that star meter just went up. Just by a kick out. Wait a minute, Lesnar.
Lesnar. Look out!
Going for the F5.
Going for the F5. F5 to Strowman. One, two, three. Brock Lesnar picked up the victory. Strowman was looking strong that whole match. And just like that, Brock Lesnar with the victory. One F5, and that was it for Strowman.
Wow.
All right, what a way to end off the Beast in the East with the Beast picking up a victory here tonight. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys did enjoy, make sure you guys do smack that like button. If you guys aren't already subscribed, make sure you do subscribe. I am almost up to 1,200 subscribers. I'm only about maybe 15, something like that away. So make sure you guys do subscribe for more WWE videos. Look at Braun, just knocked out outside the ring. And I will see you guys on Monday Night Raw.